Hello friends, welcome to this channel. Today we are going to start the new subject, and name of the subject is that is design of machine elements. Actually this subject is given for mechanical engineers which are studying in Polytechnic under MSBT. So there are 7 chapters that are included in design of machine elements. So the first topic is that is introduction to design. So this chapter is given for 20 marks. The weightage of this chapter is about 20 marks. Next one is design of joints, levers and offset links, and the weightage of these chapters are 12 marks. Next chapter is given, that is design of shafts, keys and couplings. It is given for 24 marks. Next one is design of power screws. This power screws is given for 12 marks. Next chapter is design of springs. It is given for 12 marks. Next chapter is design of threaded and welded joints. It is given for 12 marks. And last chapter, that is anti-friction bearing, it is given for 8 marks. So when we are adding all these marks, the total given, that is 100 marks. So let's start the first chapter, that is introduction to design. The first point is that is general procedure in machine design. So whenever we are designing any machine or any machine component, so it has some general procedure that we have to follow. So I have drawn here one flow chart. In this flow chart I have shown need or aim, then synthesis, or you can say mechanisms, then analysis of forces, material selection, design of elements, modifications, detailed drawing, and last one is production. So first is recognition of need. So whenever we have to design any machine or any machine component, at that time we have to make a complete statement of problem, and that problem should indicate the aim, purpose for which the machine is used. Second one is synthesis or mechanisms. So selection of suitable mechanisms and the desired motions should be selected. Next one is analysis of forces. So in this analysis of forces, we have to find out the forces which are acting on each member of the machine and the energy transmitted by the materials. After that, material selection. Now the selection of the material according to the transmission availability, after that cost and environmental conditions. So the best material should be selected for each member of the machine. Next one is design. So the next point is that is design of elements. So in design of elements, we have to find out the size of the each element by consideration of forces which are acting on each member of the machine and the permissible stresses for which the material used. But care must be taken that they should not be bend, deflect or deform than the permissible limits. Next one is the modification. So modification is necessary by considering manufacturing to reduce the overall cost of the machining. After that, detailed drawing. So detailed drawing of each member with tolerance and assembly of machine with the type of fits and the specifications for the manufacturing process is suggested. After that, once the prototype model is prepared, tested, and if it works satisfactory, then the detailed drawing will be issued to the production department for the manufacturing. So in this way, this is the total flow chart for the general procedure in machine designing. So we have to